for a fantastic day this morning. So far, I bought my chocolate, my spices, and I'm going to use my spices in this fantastic recipe here called Buñuelos. Now, this one, to me and you, is really is donuts with cottage sugar and cinnamon. Great with your coffee, great for a brunch. Your kids will love it, but be careful because it can be quite addictive. So good. Now, we start here with plain flour, which I sieved in a large bowl here. Now, what do we got here to help for the recipe? Baking powder. Then we got some anise. Then we got a pinch of salt, a little bit of caster sugar, milk, an egg, and melted butter. So very simply, put everything in a bowl. So we started with the baking powder goes in. Okay, then we got the anise. And this is probably one of my favorite smells in the world, anise. Okay, goes in, then a pinch of salt, and the sugar. Okay, what do you want to do at this stage? Just start to mix everything up. Okay. Wonderful. Now time for the milk and the egg. Now, the easiest way to do it, instead of putting the milk first and then the egg, just break the egg into the milk. Like this. Mix everything together. Ecco qua. Straight into the bowl. And once you go, now it's time to start to work everything together. Maybe you will need a little bit more flour. So just make sure you got some flour on the side, just in case. Okay, once you start to mix here, the only thing we're gonna have to add to this is melted butter. We're gonna have to make sure though that the butter is actually not hot, but is well melted like this. Okay, so this one goes in. I mean, really, the difference from this one and the donuts that we used to is the anise. It gives a nice kick to these donuts. So, start to work everything together. Okay, now what you want to do? You want to start to knead the dough, but definitely you will need more flour. So, okay, this stage, as I said, it would happen. We need just a little bit more, like this. And now, it's the time to transfer this one on a board, on a chopping board, whatever you got, that you can start to knead everything together. So make sure you flour a little bit. Okay. And the only thing left to do is use a little bit of strength. So mix everything together. And just like bread, let me show you, just like bread, look what you have to do from the outside. Goes to the inside. So out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in. So knead it for about 10 minutes. And of course, I got one already done. So this one, we leave it here. And this one is the one I prepared before, which we're gonna put it here. This one back here. Okay, at this stage, what you want to do, very, very simple. You're gonna start to have to make some little balls. So pinch it, like this, okay? Work with your hand and trying to make a round shape. Okay, this will do it. See the thickness? More or less probably about 0.5 centimeter thick. So once you are at this stage, I'm going to prepare four of this. Okay, now what you want to do, get one of these wooden spoon, you know, preferably a round one. And this is what you need to do. You need to make a hole in the middle, okay? And just push it with your finger in like that. So you get a nice round shape. Wonderful. Now the only thing we're gonna have to do is cook them. So make sure. Let's do it. Okay, at this point, the only thing you're gonna have to make sure that you got some sunflower oil or vegetable oil quite hot, because this one they need to cook quite quickly, otherwise they're gonna start to absorb all the oil. We don't want that. Okay, so straighten into the oil. Like that. What you want to achieve is Inside nice and fluffy, and outside nice and crispy. So have a look here, have a look in the pan here, and I'll show you exactly what I mean. They start to break a little bit, so that means they're gonna start to fluff it up, but then you want a nice golden coat all around. I think they're done, nice and brown. Sono bellissime. Guarda qua. Look at this one. Beautiful. Put on a kitchen towel here. Now, at this point, they're ready. And the only thing you're going to have to do is put them straight away into the sugar once they warm. Otherwise, the sugar will not stick to it. So, a little bit of caster sugar. Then what I got here is cinnamon. Goes in. And this is going to give a nice kick. So, what you want to do, just mix everything together. This. And just put them in. So we make sure that they're all nice and coated. The smell is just unbelievable. It reminds me when I was a kid. Okay, done. These are absolutely ready. Stupendi! It started to rain again, but so far so good. Signori, that's it. Grazie, thank you very much. Thank you. Well, it looks good, but I hope that you're gonna enjoy the taste. Yeah? Come on, tuck in. Let me know what you think about it. Excellent. Well, we maybe had some rain today, but it's always a great time here in Oaxaca. Join me again for another celebration of the best of Mexican food. Ciao.